All right, back on the trail of collision shapes, resources, that was what I was going to be adding with the import and export kind of realigned again. So I gotta change this up. So this is like, oh yeah, this is basically this test collision shape. Yeah, get rid of that. Got the collision shape. That means we can load it in if we go to the function registrar. We're going to be adding. It's a local one. It's back by one. It goes up physics resource collision shape loader. Or is it just under physics YAML? It's under physics YAML. Include collision shape. Include that. YAML importer. Add importer. It's going to be collision shape v1. And the import function is YAML read collision shape definition. Got to do same thing down here for removing. Distributed YAML for this right now. Put it on at the end. What's resource? Resource is the ID, right? Wait, hold on. YAML ID read required. I don't have the ptranslator because I just don't right now. Okay. And then I need the loader. I need to add. So I have that. I need to add it here. Into the application wherever I create, loading that, initializing pool. Here we go. So after arm, well, armature is down here. There's probably another location I'm missing in distributed YAML for doing this, resource loaders, collision shape. Okay, maybe not quite. I'll define reference to this. Am I just not I'll put this in here. In here, we're just going to have to add. YAML write required that. What? No. What's going on? Oh. Okay, that should mean that on the way through distributed YAML, import resource definition. See, this is importing one at a time. Oh, this one's just, yeah. Doesn't actually have any specifics to go with it, so this should be fine. Let me see if I can actually hit this case. No. Why? Box size, required node not found in here. That's what we got. Collision shape V1 box size. Required node not found, the parse is that. Interesting. I mean, it's good that it's inside a function. It's inside the area I'm looking for. Going there. Yeah, okay. Ah, subnode. Whoops. Okay, we're there. We're adding collision shape. And then presumably I'm okay. If that's the case, then that also means that in the loader, should be coming through to here pretty shortly after. Crap. Stop it, stop it, stop it. My system's not ready for this. Oh, okay. It never came through here, through to here, though. So, why? Because request resource load never occurred, did it? Because this is being called. Basically nowhere else. Interesting. I'm going to have to actually probably call it myself here. Because nothing else. For now, when it tries to load stuff for audio, visual stuff, for graphics. Like at the beginning of the thing, there's like a render call where it checks, maybe, or loads it, waits for it to be loaded. Or something? Or do I just not do that anymore? I'm just loading everything straight up anyways, I guess, right now. Oh, this is what's going on. Yeah, right here. Here, I knew it was somewhere. Just wasn't sure exactly where. I'm just going through and loading, getting everything to be loaded. Okay, there we go. We're doing this, going through, we're finding maybe the stuff. We don't actually get the stuff. Crash out without loading stuff, which is unfortunate. Very unfortunate. Okay, I want to get into the distributed YAML function where we get resource. Bam. I'm sorry, what? Shortcut. I guess that's the first question is, does it even reach inside this function? The answer is no. Is the import function even set? Yeah, it's got something. Do I just have, maybe I have the wrong function given to it? Is it just not being set, maybe? Maybe it's just skipping this? No? Because otherwise it's just null, right? Yeah. So it's being given. Then it goes inside of here. What function is this going to come out? Eventually, get me to the function, please. Wait, wait, wait. I was there. I was there. I was finally there. I was here. I mean, I can get resource right here. My index is 16. Wait a second. You're 16. You're supposed to be 17. That's my bad. After all, that's a lot of template to go through as well. Okay, we're here. Great. Okay, so the first stem. No ID group, that's great. Second stem is this. Just seven, that's great. What is the path? No, it's not the right one. Nope. 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 No. Actually, I'm interested. What does this look like for parsing? Right, 15? Yeah, that's correct. Path collision, test collision shape. Okay, here we are. 17. Yeah. Okay, right. Okay, we got that. We got the resource node. No. Collision shape, yes. We're inside, we do it. It's great. It's great. And we got this. And this, it's 111. Okay, we're coming back out. We do this. This becomes a new of that. We'll remove that in. Okay. They return it. Okay. Now we process the create info. So then why was it failing a moment ago? What? Or it was just because of the wrong index ID. Yes, it would have been the wrong index ID. That's why it was failing. Yeah, okay. So otherwise, it should never hit this. It's always going to hit that instead. Let's run it. Render mesh is like, ooh, paramedic. Yeah, it's just changing location. Makes sense. So now I have collision shapes. And one thing I need to do is I need to wait for collision shapes to be loaded. add Okay. If we have this, then that means we can go back down to do system. Now I don't really have an insert or remove thing for collision for resources, and I don't really think it's something I need. I mean, no, I don't quite think so. See, right now it's pulling in state pools. I also need resource pools. Okay, that's actually something I want to change up here. Don't want to actually have these here. It'll be included here. However, I need the structs. Okay, now we do the collision shape thing. So, source pools, vision shape dot find. Rigid body, which we already have, collision shape. That also actually means back in application, I need to specify that this. ID create, oh, ID persistent, and then it's 17 for the index. Okay, back here, I got that. Okay. If we still can't find it, that means we need to add it. Collision shape. Oh no, I don't want to do the loader thing. I really need to rethink more on the resources. I really do. I'm gonna have to put that on the to-do list. To-do file. Rework resources again. Okay. Okay, this again, back to this. I don't have loaders with me. This isn't even the right one, is it? No, here it is. So I got resource, so it's I'm looking for what is it? Collision shape. Make sure it's not. This is very deep because this is like a really cold path. This is going to be the unlikely path that almost never happens. And right now, all rigid bodies need to have a collision shape to work. So it'll be a super rare path. So I want to have the regular path be as normally fast as usual. I can actually just say like unlikely, like that. Valid ID. Add it as a resource now. So got this P rigid body collision shape. And then we need a loader. Okay. For the moment, dot collision shape. And that. Need to include memory. I already do. Interesting. Oh. That. No, we can do this. If that, then we can release this. Wait, no, P collision shape equals dot get. If it was successfully added, we can release it. Otherwise, we can. Otherwise, we are here. That means it already exists. Maybe it was added by something else just a moment ago. So then, what we can do instead is just pull it in through this again. Or rather, P new collision shape. This is being initialized here. So we do that. If not, while. So we just loop through until something sticks. We do this. So actually. This while like that, since we're also adding it at the same time. In this case, it already has to exist. In this case, we can optionally add it if we can't find it. Because this may be the first time that anyone's requested, hey, I'm going to use this collision shape. So we create it here. We try to find it. We failed to find it. So we either add it if we can. If we fail to add it, we delete it and then we come back through. Can I find it? If I can find it now, then it's because someone else added it instead of me. Or if I did add it, I don't delete it and then I come back through and I find it because I added it. And then we leave. Interesting. Okay, so it's P collision shape. Data dot collision shape dot get. Actually, no, I need to make sure that's loaded first. If not, load state loaded. It's not loaded. We need to request it to be loaded. So p collision shape dot in request load. Then we return or okay. If the collision shape load state is resource load state failed, if it failed, then that means we just can't use it again. Otherwise, because it failed to load for whatever reason, who knows? Otherwise we request it to be loaded, and then we have. I need some data to persist. Like what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a list of items that are awaiting loading on resource. Because I already came through the system saying, hey, you know, yeah, I need some form of ID. Awaiting resources. Some kind of entity like this, where it's is awaiting resources. Okay, one thing I can do after these then would be I need a resource. Yeah, the resource loaders. Pass them on. So what I'd have to do at this point is auto try to add objects of whatever awaiting or just iterator resource loaders and resource pools and state pools and the iterator null pointer. Like that. Waiting for resources. What would happen is otherwise. Entity. So right now, what's going to happen is because we don't have, at first, we seriously don't have it loaded or anything like that right now. Whoops. Okay, we do this. Process physics. So we got P simulation state. Loaders. Sorry, set. I've updated this a little bit. So realistically, what's going to happen? It should hit here. First run through. Collision shape is basically always null pointer. We do this. It does exist in this case. If we don't run into that, we do run into this case. It is loaded. I'm loading it asynchronously using that other thing. So right now it does actually work, and then it goes and it falls down. Okay. Let's see if we can remove that piece of the code then, where I'm deliberately just adding it to be loaded here. I don't want to force the issue of it being loaded now. I just want to come in, it's not loaded, it doesn't even exist, first case. Or, you know, it'll be declared, but it won't be defined or loaded because it's being imported with the rest of the resources at first. So, that, we exist, fantastic. I come along into this, I'm not. Oh, right, that's the wrong one. Whoops. Okay, this time, I go in, it exists, but it's not loaded, right? Yeah, it's not failed, so I can do it. I can add it to the awaiting resources to be done. Request load now. It's just staying there. It's not coming through again. That is not what I was looking for. Oh, because I did that. Yeah, I don't want to add stuff and then do that. So I need to do the opposite. I need to have this be done first. Yes. Yeah, it needs to be first. I need to empty this out before I start adding stuff in that object. Or can I just, I mean, it doesn't really matter if it's first or last. Either way, it's going to cost basically the same. So we'll just do it this way instead. Okay, let's just get rid of unlikely then. I don't really. This whole case is unlikely. We go in. Did that. Gonna come, we don't even come back through again anyways. Interesting. I do add it, right? Like, we added it. Great. Do we ever come to this point? We do. How did you get added? Oh, I need to leave. Whoopsie. Otherwise, I just like between this point and that, it actually already loaded, maybe? Oof. That's not good. Right, because this doesn't quite exist yet. Okay, this is the awaiting resource case. Now this time we'll go in, we'll it'll be loaded. We can go ahead and create the thing. Wait, did we actually go in twice? We did. Why? I was added twice. Oh, and then the second time he'll go in and say, hey, you know, this guy exists, yes, and he's, yeah. Whew. Okay. Because it would have been added both from the rigid body and the position. So that, yeah, that does make sense. Nice. So what I can do now is, if I was to go into the loading of physics shapes, and I was to delay it by a ridiculous amount for whatever reason, because I hate myself. I'm sleeping for a few seconds. Amazing. Amazing. Run this, it'll stay at like the original position for like 4 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, like that. It's also pausing everything else for some reason, and I'm not entirely sure why. Unless it's because I have like this is supposed to be an asynchronous job, right? If I, okay, what's the timing happening, right? See, that is, yeah, it's drawing frames, it's just not drawing this stuff until I add that. I don't know. It looks really off. Okay, but at least this is actually looking pretty much as I had hoped. Okay. Well, okay. At this point, I really don't understand why. Okay, actually, under here, let's re-add this. I'm truly actually interested. Like, why is it pausing everything at that point? Like, what's going on? So I pause it right here. What's going on? The main is in process armature state. It's doing something. Okay. It's still going and doing other stuff. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. What happened? Terminated in here. Why? And it's not actually ending either. Why? What's. You're waiting. Okay. We're trying to deinitialize. We're waiting for that. He's doing something. He's loading stuff still. What? Is he just like reloading every few seconds or something? Like, what's. In system, get rid of this log. Let's just see what's happening. Like, is it just kind of attempting to load looking for this to happen over and over and over. I think it's just trying to loop through loading the same resource again and again. Yeah. If I was to get rid of the sleep. It tries it twice. It's probably because it keeps going through this over and over and trying to re, because it's not loaded. If would that this help? I mean, this is kind of the wrong problem to be looking at anyways. It should just be able to do this without an issue anyways. See, this kind of goes back down to the fact that I kind of need to rework resources to more properly have like figuring out a sourcing mechanism to not go through. See, now we got two, and now it's going to override it while it's already in use. Okay, if I'm going to do improvements to resource loading, I'll leave that for another thing. Otherwise, okay, moving back to system, because that's another whole other pickle I've got to re-look at. Now that I've gotten more, because I've also got to figure out like the loader system needs to be shifted around a bit as well, removed from the resources themselves and moved more to where. To somewhere else. Not exactly sure where, but that's gonna have to come along eventually. So we don't need this here. Still having a shared physics world. Okay, what I'm going to do now then. Is I'm going to shift all these to like a separate library now so I can do some proper isolation of all this stuff. So faux physics, which isn't going to include source and eventually test this.txt. Gonna add physics. I don't even include plugin anymore, do I? No, I do not. Is there even anything in there? No, it's just an empty folder. Cool. Include flow. Whoops. Physics. Physics resource. Which includes these three, 1, 2, and 3. Oh, that means we're also going to need libs for YAML source. Move those in there. This is what this would go into source for now. System source. System is a header, but not that. Body system goes into just physics for the moment. Inside libs, we'll have a YAML. Include. Oh, YAML source. Just goes all the way down in there. Clean up this because there's nothing else in here. This directory goes away. Okay, back down to the root directory. We'll need to bring over the bullet stuff. So, faux physics, the roots you make lists, there it is. Okay, in here. Okay, just close everything. There's too much stuff. So we're going for the any dependencies, the declaration, all this stuff. That's great. So we're not going to have this stuff though, actually. Place them all. Bam. Don't need this. Clear that up. Just clear all these up. So, where's Bullet? It's not even in here. It's in the subdirectory, isn't it? Or it would have been in the source directory. I probably killed it. Yeah. Go to the trash. Physics, you make lists. Restore that. Can't restore that. Can I just open in Kate? Not quite what I'm looking for. Where on earth did I declare bullet? Here it is. It is in the root thing. Dependencies, that. Okay, great. Bullet include directories. Great. Bring that in. Bullet libraries. Bring that in. Great. Anything else? Physics, source, libs. Get rid of it out of here. Just leave that be empty. Okay, this you see, make lists in here. Actually, no, I won't even know. Wait, did I just accidentally kill the physics thing I needed? Yeah, I did, somehow. Restore it, please. Thank you. Yes. Ah, libs YAML. Going into this is the one I wanted to remove. Okay. Faux physics resource, rich body system. Okay. Okay. Oh, yes. That is a problem because these are not defined yet. Well, okay, well, I do have some advantages. Because what I really need from this, I don't need the entire pool. I need specific items. Okay, let me double check what exactly I do need. So I'll go to the source. Yeah, I have to go to the source side. Close the others. Close that up. Close that up. Okay. You're right. We don't have that. Be like back. One, two, three, source. Like that, right? Let's just see, does it build? Doesn't build. Why? Because this, yes, doesn't exist. It's great. I know that. Log that. Okay. So I need foe. I need foe ECS. Shape pool. So what's going to happen is that this is going to be taking in foe MNOP, foe physics. Becomes foe physics resource collision shape pool like that. Foe physics resource collision shape pool should be well. Maybe just need to re. Okay, that's better. Foe resource created in foe base. Ah, yes, I need foe resource. Be included beforehand. Then these need to be reworked. This is a local. Same thing here. What? Right, yeah. Okay. Let's get the YAML one going. So, PhotPhysics YAML collision shape. Okay. So it's not this, not really that. Faux ECS YAML, faux physics. Because that's, yeah, it's still going to be going through that. Okay, we're in here. We're going to have to include faux physics YAML export.h. Need to have this very long faux physics YAML export. These are the two items we're exporting from here. We'd also need to have this. Okay, we double check. Faux physics YAML collision shape, okay. Faux physics source. Make sure the guards are correct. Faux physics, rigid body. Okay. Faux physics system. Is there anything to export from here? No. Realistically, I don't actually need this here since it's just a pointer, so I can just struct that. And then I can actually rip that out of here, move it down to the source area, which has already got it. So we're good on that one. Do I need this? Like, again, same thing here, right? Struct that. I do need that. Or do I need, okay. I need that for the ID. I need an atomic. And I can struct this for declare that. Then I need the exports. Collision shape. Okay, now we're back down to this point where I'm trying to include for system. I'm going back to include the resource and state pools, even though I don't need all of them. Okay, actually, that's something I probably do here. Include. I want to do a system, so get rid of that one. This can be a regular header. Physics rigid body, that's great. Bullet dynamics, common. Don't need, because it's brought in by this. Whoops. By this, right? Yeah. Resource ID is brought in from that. I'm just going to have to manually specify the types. There's no other way I can really think about it. Like, they're very specific types. Like, I need what? I need the loader. The loader's local, so that's fine. Physics, that's fine. It's really the position. I need the position. That's the only external item I'm working with here, really. It's not even in here, is it? It'd be part of system. Okay, let's do that. So first of all, can scrapping these. This is to be replaced with wait. In here is declared as that. I'm not sure if I can forward declare like a template like that. Faux entity ID. Well, no, I'd already have everything I need to forward declare this. Or declare it up here. So I'll do that. I need this here as well. So that gets rid of that. So let's do that all the way through, shall we? What was it? It was a position 3D, right? State pools. Where are you? The component positions that I need are available. No, it's not. It's not info. It's in the bring up application. Okay. Okay, I may actually have to do like another one at the same time. Like move, like what's position, right? This is position 3D with these. These would have to be split up into a YAML sublibrary. It just keeps going on and on. Yeah. Okay. And this oh, position descriptor pool. Oh, what? It also has a VK descriptor set still as well. Well, I'm going to have to split position out anyways. It's going to develop into a larger system eventually. So may as well do it now. It's forcing the issue right now. Prevent, like, because if I just continue to leave this stuff here, it's just going to continue to like there'll be more and more connections between this and other systems. It's going to become an unmanageable, untangled web that will take forever to extricate from in the future. I should probably do it now, properly separated it now. Establish clear lines between things now. Sorry, if and def, oh, position 3D HPP. I mean, it's a very light library for the moment, for sure. Do this. Okay, we do we need bullet? No. We'll need this. We need position dependency on GLM. We need to add GLM is that. Do we have a resource? No. ECS? Yes. No. Even in foe, is there even really a dependency on foe? Not at the moment. Not that I can think of. Okay, close others, save that for the moment. Need the position 3D. Okay, for the moment, yeah, it's just these. And Vulcan. That's unfortunate. That is, it's just a plain old struct otherwise. Very simple. There's no source to go along with it, so technically this is in interface library, isn't it? Oh, no, this one. Don't need this. There's nothing to export. It's a header only. Nothing to bring in there either. That does leave, however, this one. So this libcyaml, these guys, position YAML. ECS, no. Position, yes. Yeah. So this, we're going to include YAML CPP. This, we're going to include position YAML export. We're going to include position 3d.hpp, so I can get the struct, which I need. These are currently in line. They don't have to be, because these things are actually going to be going into here in a moment. It's not in line. It's not in line. Okay. Includes YAML. Now I need to add H, Y, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, positions after. Okay. Can't find it. Why can it not? Faux position. Ah. I still need the include directory, if not the exports. Mm-hmm. Okay, with all that out of the way, let us clear out this. Is there anything I'm missing in here? Not really. Let's remove it. Wait for the very slow process to complete. Add it here. So what's going to happen is that this is now going to include faux position. So that's, I'm not even going to compile system action for the moment. Griffin shape pool needs ID. Lot of little problems. Descriptor pool now in new location. Unknown type, phase, collision, shape, something rather. This, yeah, no longer required. This is also gone. Unit phys, okay, these are replaced with. Okay. So what else did I need? I needed the foe fizz collision shape pool. Class that. Class that. So ECS, yes. Now it shouldn't link, even if it's going to complete collision shape. Okay. Got a whole bunch of things open again. Let's close them all. Go back to basics. This and this. So what we've got. This is what we need to pass on. Remove object only require the rigid body pool. The loader. State pools, resource pools going away. Not quite. Clean up these last two items. Okay, we've got undefined reference to some things inside of wherever I'm using these. Not exporting them, that's why. F5, let's see how it runs. Terrifyingly, it's... Oh, I mean, that's not hooked up anymore. Yes, I know. But everything else is going okay. So, what was the declaration of that type in a moment? It was just that, right? State pool, position, yeah. I can copy that in for this moment. Just make sure. Okay, have I reached parity with what it was before I started moving everything? That is a good question. I imagine I'm pretty close. Okay, it looks like I am. Great. Okay, let's get these things committed, and boy, that's a lot of stuff in here. Then I time to clean up basically for the today's items. So first of all, position 3D has been moved. It's no longer there. It's these camera has been updated for that. Resource pools has been updated for. No, state pools. Stage that. Stage that. Do I need data pool? Not yet for the map. That's the old type. Collision shape stuff, entity. That's new. That's also the new one. It's collision shape stuff. Okay, application. Everything else should be the same for the moment. So don't get rid of that. Get rid of that. Position items. As well as in libs, adding the one line. Okay, this is all physics. Oh, and that means in the main down here, adding these two. What? Oh, it was a rename. Okay, it's considering this the rename because it's the majority of the code. Then this one is the new, yeah. Okay. Situated. For also, this should also what? This should also improve. Entanglements lower. Position chunking, which I haven't even really delved into yet. Okay, that leaves whatever is left in here to be the physics stuff. Okay, for the rest, we'll just kind of get the physics basics stuff in. Just remove that. So we'll add this. Yep. Do I need rigid body? Yes, for the declaration of this, I do. Okay, there's still stuff to be done. Here right now, it's still using the same thing. Okay. I'm pretty okay with that stuff. Now, I want to see if I can try to like forward declare these so I don't have to bring all this in here. It's not needed. I mean, basically, this is just a pointer at this point. I don't need. So, what if. Okay, rigid body. How would I declare this? Okay, system doesn't actually need rigid body right now. What I could do, ID. What if I take this out? And then I just say, hey, you know, it's a class. That. What if it's this? Then I say using that equals faux data pool of faux TID. Okay, that'll be included, yes. That means I can move defer that to in here somewhere. System.cpp. Right here. Does that work? Chromium, help me, help me, help me. For declare template type def. So unless I want to actually also forward declare. Okay, maybe not. Not so happy about that.
Okay, what I need to do now is I need. What do I need? I need to be able to import and export a rigid body type, which is, for all intents and purposes, just the mass and the collision shape ID. I need, yeah, this. Actually, this is probably more apt here. Okay, I am getting tired. I'm starting to get real sloppy here. String, no translator. I do even have a translator. I don't think I do. Ooh, no, I need a translator here. Okay. Dang it. Where do I find this? Group translator, info ECS. I don't even need it actually defined here. I just need to pass it along. Nice. Position is like the only one that doesn't have. Okay, so this is something I'm going to have to work on as well. Is I need to, let me get the list out. For state data, change to the more flexible new YAML parsing system. Rather than hard coding all these. I mean, the writing may still require a bit of fancy footwork, but the reading. No, that is reading. Reading could be made much easier. Writing, not so much. Well, maybe. Okay, I don't really know yet. Define the ID. Whoa. This would mean something along the lines of this. Render mesh should then have another type coming out. Not quite yet, though. Because I didn't add it. Node and group translator data. Am I missing something? Oh, yes, okay. I didn't rename the definitions yet. Mass ID 17. Okay, I guess I can be fairly happy about this. Okay, if I move this up, I'm not reading this data in yet. Okay, so I guess, make sure I add that. Yes, add these for the moment. Yes, application. Yes, rigid body. Yes, yep. And yep, okay. A bunch more stuff is kind of there. Physics is mostly there. I'm just going to have to do next time probably some refinements. Like maybe some renames and that I'm not entirely settled on. And then I'll commit this and then I'll have to move on to like probably something probably to do with resource loading. Because there was that the bug words. Well, not even a bug. I mean, it's just a logical or just a complete oversight in how I mean, the resource system I came up with in the first place was really rickety. The second one that I'm kind of sitting on right now is a lot better, but still, it was grown out of the first, more like a, and it was grown not like naturally, it was grown like, it was like cancerous growth, rather than something that really should have been, needs to be kind of cut back down and reworked properly. Not with the benefit of hindsight now, I should say. But that's it for now, so cheers.